A very good morning to you and welcome back to our Proactive Investors studio. Here with me today from Far East Gold, it's CEO Shane Menere. Shane, great to meet you.
Great to meet you, Elisha. Thank you for having me.
It's interesting, Shane, today Far East Gold put out an announcement, the first drill hole drilled at Aloe Rek. You have quite a few considerations here, but I think one of the most important things is that you've increased the strike length at the Victory Vein by a sizable chunk. Tell us more.
5,500 metres, Alicia, increased by. So that takes up to us up to about 18,500 metres across the entire Woyla tenement, which is really exciting for us. We've had our mapping crew, our geos, heading out to site, looking at all of these outcrops and these surface expressions, and we've managed to come up with this significant increase in strike length, as I said, that extra 5,500 metres.
That's bringing it over to 18.5 kilometres in total, 18.5. Which is an important result for the team. One other thing I'd like to highlight, though, is the high-grade nature of these results. What more can you tell us?
So the Victory Vein is the most southern vein at the Woyla Prospect. And we've been making our way down there for quite some time as we've been scout drilling and exploring. Now, we've finally gotten down there, pushed a little bit of a road through where we needed to get through as we've methodically done our scout drilling exploration across all of the other prospect areas. And Aloe Rek was the Barrick number one choice, and they named it the Victory Vein. And it's turned out to be a victory. We're getting great results down there. We're seeing some nice meters and so we're seeing some very nice grade as well. Now, this is very exciting for us. In the past, in much of the other areas, we've been seeing some good meters and we've been seeing some good grade, but not particularly coming together. Now, Aloe Rek, as I said, the victory is certainly showing itself at the Victory Vein, and we're seeing these meters and these grades together.
Now, it's always nice to see the drilling pay dividends in this regard. My understanding, though, is that Victory Vein is not a new prospect, as it were. It's had attention in the past. What can you tell us about the context here?
Yeah, so Woyla has been owned by a couple of the big players in the past, Barrick and Newcrest being just a couple of them. And as I mentioned, the Victory Vein was Barrick's number one choice to go into. Now, the region has been a little difficult to get in and drill for the ownership or since the creation of the tenement over 27 years ago. But, you know, working with community very closely as Far East Gold does and working with the environmental side of things very closely up there with the appropriate government departments as Far East Gold does, we've ingratiated ourselves well and truly with the local government and the local community, and they've opened the doors for us to come on in and do that proper exploration. So the first time, as I mentioned, in 27 years that the exploration and drilling has been done, and really exciting times to get in there, and especially very exciting with the local support that we're getting to actually get into a position of transitioning into mining operations at some point soon.
All right, Shane, so you're putting the pedal to the metal over at the Victory Vein prospect. I'm sure investors will be eager to know, though, what's next for the project?
Well, plenty on next. We've recently done some aeromag work, some magnetic mapping and so forth to help us better understand the tenement, confirming some of our drill targeting and creating some new targets for us as well. So obviously we can't confirm this at the moment, but we suspect that many of these veins, as they travel on that north-south trajectory through that structural corridor, do join up. And if that's the case, you know, we drop those test drill holes through there, there'll be some significant meters or even kilometers added again to that strike length. Now, there's one other thing that's come up, which is a magnetic anomaly showing a potential mineralized porphyry system under the Woyla prospect. And we don't know what that actually means. It's purely a magnetic anomaly that's showing up right now, but it's all indications are that it's a potential porphyry that may be feeding this system. So our next step is to go in there and really take a good look and see if there is something there, if it is porphyry or if it is just an anomaly.
And Shane, just a quick one for you, last off the bat. Obviously, we're seeing some positive and encouraging movements in the prices of metals like gold and copper. What does this mean in terms of your broader exploration endeavours?
Well, Vares Gold, it really is a copper gold project or company. The gold price is looking very, very positive. As of today, it's over $22.50 US per ounce. Copper price of copper is going up. This is all obviously driven on some political uncertainties and the technology boom for copper in particular. Now, we think we're very well positioned to take advantage of these market trends. We're certainly seeing gold doing very, very well right now. Copper, we think, is going to go up, or the market's indicating an increase towards the end of the year. So combine that with the work that we're doing down in Trenggalek, being fundamentally a copper prospect. We intend to do some exploration drilling down there, and hopefully that coincides very well with the market conditions for the bullish outlook on copper.
Far East Gold CEO Shane Menere, I'm sure these latest results out of the Woyla and Victory Vein prospects are a great start to your week. We're looking forward to hearing more about your next steps very soon.
Thanks, Felicia. Appreciate the time.